This is yet another Zombie Survivors by Awesome Games Studio. Man, that is some, pressure. If you're going to call yourself Awesome Games Studio, you better make awesome games. This is a bullet heaven, so something along the lines of Vampire Survivor, Scarlet Tower, and about a bajillion other similar types of games. I normally play this one on... Oh, goodness, I don't want any. Actually, I do want that one. Take it back. Normally play this one on Steam Deck, but right now I'm playing on my desktop. If you're curious about how it plays on Steam Deck, it plays very well. Settings do tend to get turned down a little bit, if nothing else. Much lower resolution than my desktop, but, not bad overall. It's a good-looking game, and as I said, it's basically a bullet heaven, so you're going to run around. Lots of auto-firing. I'm basically just playing with one hand while I'm petting my cat with the other, and letting the game decide where to fire, because I'm okay with that in most of these. And I need to stop and sneeze. Now, unlike a bunch of the other games, but not all of them, this one is a little different because, as you see, we're starting with one character here. We're playing with the Huntress, and we've been upgrading our bow as we go. But we have an SOS signal, nice arrow pointing to the north, and that's going to be for a very good reason. We're not going to totally take advantage of it just yet, but I'm going to show you right away here what this is for. And this kind of gets into how you can really do some different builds in this game, and it really does add a little bit of more replayability. So right now we can recruit an additional character. We can recruit either the tank or the SWAT character, but right now I'm just going to liberate, let the rescue person take shelter in the military base and receive a level up and 1200 bucks instead, because I want the upgrade right now. I want to work on upgrading the main or the first character's weapon here as much as I can, because that's going to be the money maker right there. And let's just keep pumping up multi-shot, because that's the next level. Basically, you'll see that there are kind of little dots under each upgrade. That's going to tell you how upgraded it is and how many total upgrade levels there are. We have a yellow arrow down at the bottom of the screen. We're going to follow that one to this box right here. Stand in the circle for a moment. And we don't ever stop moving as far as I'm concerned. So health regen plus 7 while moving sounds fantastic. I will very infrequently stop moving. It's generally only when like this, when I know it's completely safe to do so. And maybe when, let's take Eagle Eye. You are stopping to open up a new box or to rescue a survivor. So the next time that we get an option to rescue a survivor, I think we'll go ahead and take it, because I just wanted, like I said, I wanted to focus primarily on upgrades for this character first. And in fact, here we'll just go ahead and pull in everything via the magnet and see if that'll give us enough for two levels. There we go. So we've got last level of multi-shot. So we are firing, starting from one arrow and now firing oodles of them at once. Looks like four at once. I don't know, I didn't pay attention, honestly. It's kind of interesting that, each character, you have different upgrades for the weapons. And each character also, there's an upgrade path you need to follow of upgrading the character itself. So, again, much like many of the other bullet heavens, there's a lot of grinding involved and a lot of gradual... I don't want freezing arrows. We're going to take another level of Eagle Eye. A lot of grinding and a lot of playing. A lot of dopamine hits as you slowly upgrade everything. We'll take the money modifier, that's fine. I don't really care about luck right now. And you'll basically start with kind of a level one character. And right now, these guys, all of the characters that are currently in the game, as of the time I'm playing it, are all maximum upgraded. However, there's an update that will be coming soon that I think is going to add the next level of them, and in fact, by the time this video is posted, it's possible that may be out, because the beta was posted. There we go. I want explosive arrows. Thank you very kindly. The beta update was posted basically kind of over the break between Christmas and New Year's. And so I'm kind of expecting that we'll have the upgrade available in place or somewhere around when this video is posted. And if not, it won't be much longer. Like I said, it might already be in place by the time this video posts. It's funny, I kind of... We'll take a tank. That's fine. It kind of doesn't matter. I'm playing on the default difficulty, so I could basically fall asleep and be fine because I have so many upgrades right now. It's just kind of redonkulous, but, you know, whatever. It's kind of how it rolls. I was going to say, I had originally recorded a video for this game some time ago, and it was shortly after I did that the game received a very significant upgrade with a lot of considerable changes, and at that point I decided, you know what? I don't think I want to post the video because too many things changed from the time I recorded to when I had that video edited and ready to go. So I've kind of been delayed, so to speak, in getting everything posted and having to put together a new one. I'm not worrying about re-rolling any of these things right now. I'm saving those more for ability upgrades. So now that the game is more or less in a stable place, like I said, by the time this one posts, it'll probably be updated again, and I'm just gonna have to accept that because I don't think I'm gonna be able to do this yet again. Timing and what it is, trying to get everything recorded for the channel. We'll go ahead and take, we'll take saw blade drone, that's fine. It's just your typical spin, you know, around and slowly slice everything up. Once you get it upgraded, it's actually pretty good. You know, it starts off weak. Level one, of course. Only one saw blade, but we'll work on that. I do want to get the weapon upgraded, and we'll go ahead and take medic. Medic is kind of the secret weapon in this game, believe it or not. Once you have the medic fully upgraded, I don't think it's the case anymore. And in fact, it's one of the major changes that came in that previous update I mentioned. But you could get to a spot where the medic essentially allowed you to never lose. Now we get four options because we have three characters in place now, and we're just going to go ahead and take the shotgun because I do want to get the tank's weapon upgraded. That is kind of important to me. I mean, right now we're doing all of our damage based on the weapons with only one ability in place that's doing any sort of additional damage, that of course being the saw blade drone. But if you want to keep going on, we're going to take explosive arrows all the way because that way we get maximum arrows, three arrows that explode, or is it four? I don't know, whatever. It's a bunch. And it's going to let us continue on for a while. And we'll take another, Yeah, you know what? We don't need any of the other things just yet. We'll just take another Eagle Eye. That way we can continue to work on our main weapon damage. I'm fine with that. But as I was saying, the medic kind of let you cheese things pretty well because the medic has, as you just saw... Oh, sure. Take that one. Actually, you know what? We'll take this one. Weapon fire rate plus 5 and armor plus 5. That's fine. It's not that big a deal. I mean, we're definitely going to be getting hit here before long. Don't you worry about that. That will absolutely happen, but... The medic, basically, you know, being a medic, focuses on recovery. And even though they do have some pretty decent weapons that, you know, not bad, definitely worth looking into. The two main things that you want out of the medic, and I mean, I guess you could say three, transplantology. That's the one we just saw there being one of them as well. But the main one is the regeneration and reanimation. With the regeneration, you get a pretty decent, I would say, pretty decent... you know what? Here, we'll take the stim pack. That's fine. Get a pretty decent regenerate. Now, if you look at the top there, health bar is 1450. That's how much health we have. The stim pack is active now because you can see how much faster we move for, like, three whole seconds. I'm not a fan of how long or how short, maybe more correctly, some of these buffs last, but they get a little better once you continue to upgrade them. I mean, that's another second on there. 4 seconds is better than three, but still not great in my book. But between all of the health regen, there you go, plus 5, and everything else, I mean, you end up... Sure, we'll go ahead and just kind of start hitting random things at this point. I'm kind of okay with that. You end up being incredibly sturdy, and if you are somehow unable to regenerate the health you need to keep moving, then the medic can reanimate you. He can basically pick your team up once every, I don't know, 60 seconds or so when you... It's either 60 or 120 once you get it fully upgraded. And it used to be that you could just basically trigger that constantly. I mean, you could almost just stand still and you'd be totally fine because you would do so much health regen that you could basically just kind of hang out for quite a while and it wouldn't be that big of a deal. Here, we'll go ahead and finish out Eagle Eye just so our weapons are really good because we're still going to work on them a little bit. But that got changed so that the number of times you can reanimate it effectively gets reduced, so you can't really just constantly reanimate and pick yourself up all the time anymore, which I never really took advantage of that. It sounded like one of those things that would be fun to play with, but I don't know. I didn't really ever go on an endless run that took forever and ever and ever. Eventually, the endless runs would end, which I should probably talk about that too right now. We're doing a standard timed run, so 20 minutes is basically what we're looking at. We just need to survive for 20. And I mean, I haven't even really talked about the various bosses and everything yet, but we'll get there. Speaking of bosses, there's one right there. But we're doing a regular timed run, so survive for 20 minutes, but there are endless runs as well. And there are a couple of different other styles too, because there's a hardcore run or a more difficult run, essentially timed run, as I think there's also a timed or a hardcore, more challenging endless run as well. That one I can't remember off the top of my head. We'll take a look at the options once we're done here. But the way this one kind of rolls, there's not necessarily one big bad that you're waiting until the very end to get to. You've more or less seen all of the bosses that are available on this map, with the exception of maybe one of them. I'm not 100% sure yet. So that's the, I don't know, the witch type character there that summons a bunch of plagued insects sort of thing to come and say hello to you. And we also have a crazy chainsaw wielding person who's a whole lot of fun. Sure, whatever. It doesn't matter. We'll just take a very slight bonus to dodge as we occasionally open up chests. It's not that big a deal, whatever. But then there's also a very large guy that I don't remember what he has for a weapon off the top of my head. But he's kind of a pain in the butt. He might just be one that doesn't even have a weapon because, quite frankly, he doesn't really need one. Yeah, see, there's your reanimation. Invincibility after 2 seconds. HP restored 100, cooldown 120 seconds. I don't think we're going to need that. And now that I've said that, we are not going to make it till the end. Just you wait and see. Especially if I just keep walking in these fields that are very clearly marked to be damaging. Duh. But as this continues on, we will get more and more of the bosses showing up, like the green guy there, the big green guys. Those are more like elite monsters. Now there's I thought he was a chainsaw. No, he is an axe wielder. Okay. Well, that was the big guy with the axe. I thought he had a chainsaw. I really did. That's funny. I saw the axe pop up and I thought, no, that's not right. It's a chainsaw, but okay, it's an axe. It's not Texas Chainsaw Massacre. There he is. There's the big guy. We give him a second here. Oh, he'll just die. I was going to say he's going to charge us, but he just fell over and he dead. So whatever, it's fine. Here, we'll take another saw blade drone. There we go. We're up to 4 of these guys now. That's not too shabby. And we'll take the shotgun upgrade on the tank character because I do still want to get that character upgraded for weapons. And since things have been going pretty well, I haven't really been worrying about the medic. If we're playing on a higher difficulty, oh, there we go. The horde evolves. We're now up to danger 3. Got a red arrow guiding us to the next boss. There he is. You're not even going to get a chance to charge because the Huntress is just that good right now. But if we were on a harder difficulty, I would definitely be pumping the health regen on the medic. As it stands right now, we're doing just fine with the +7 that we got. As long as we're moving, we're getting a little bit of health back, and it's totally fine. I'm going to say we take the ability cooldown because that's going to let us have things like the stim pack and eventually, potentially, the reanimation up sooner, along with this bombing strike run thing that the tank has. You know, it's kind of interesting. All the characters have quite a few abilities, and it does get to be a little annoying when you're going for a certain build, which is where you need to have your banish and reroll stuff ready to go. And I'm not worrying too much about any of that stuff yet, just because I've been kind of okay with what we've had as options. There we go. We're up to the maximum level now on the saw blade drone. My only real gripe with the saw blade drone, by the way, is that I just wish it were a little faster. It's just a little too slow for my taste, but it is doing some damage, so I can't really complain all that much about it. We'll go ahead and do transplantology, because that's going to give us... Nah, we'll just do field surgery, so we'll just take some additional regen. That's fine here. Let me see if I can take some damage so we can see how quickly this is pumping up now. There we go. Here, we should take some damage momentarily. Keep parrying it. Yeah, we're basically taking so little damage that we're able to regen it essentially immediately. That's kind of hilarious. Like I said, not playing on a super high level of difficulty, and I do have most upgrades. Not all, but most upgrades at this point, so whatever. Give me some damage. It makes no difference. If we get back to moving again, then our health regen really pumps up. There we go. We took some good solid damage there, but it's still going up right now, even though we were standing in a field where we were taking damage. So, you know, once the horde evolves a little more, that's not going to continue to be the case. I mean, just to be clear, it's not like there's no challenge at all. It does get dicey. It's just we're, for these early levels right now, this kind of early stage, sure, we'll take the defeating a boss grants you a little bit of a boost there, because quite frankly, as we continue on, we are going to have a lot of bosses. I didn't mean to pick that magnet up. I meant to leave that one. It generally pays in my book to leave a couple of these things behind so that you have them as you need them here and there. Here, we'll go ahead and upgrade your handgun. That'll be fine. I don't know how far we're going to be able to get on all the various upgrades. My hope is that we'll be able to get the tank's weapon upgraded to the final weapon. And it would be good if we could get the medics upgraded, but I'm really more concerned with getting the health regen and possibly the transplantology, just so we can get some additional life stealing going on. The mine, you know, it's funny, like some of these are not bad. Like a lot of them are actually really good, but they're just not what I'm looking for right now. So we'll just go ahead and take a reroll and we'll take the handgun on the medic. The tank is actually pretty useful right now, now that he's been upgraded to the pump shotgun. He's not perfect or anything by any stretch, but he's definitely more useful than he was. He can sort of hold his own against the trash mobs now, which is good. Especially when you consider that we have such a high critical rate with the regular weapons. I mean, you can see it's just a sea of yellow. I mean, when you see the white numbers pop up, those are the non-critical hits. And obviously they're a little smaller and not as obvious to see, but it's a lot of yellow right now. And I'm okay with that. That's kind of what I want. My style in this game has more or less been to rely on weapons. I didn't mean to pick that one up, but we'll take it. Sure, we'll just take some extra XP. That'll give us a couple extra levels by the time we're done. Probably not too much, but a little bit. Would have been much better to have earlier on, but here we are. I'm going to focus on the shotgun since it's the better weapon. That'll get him closer to his final upgrade. And then we'll go pick up a free level here by rescuing this survivor. There you go. Shotgun is at maximum, so the next upgrade that we get, if we're able to get it as a choice, we'll be able to upgrade the tank's weapon. And I already know which one I want to go with. I don't want to go with the rocket launcher. I want to go with the minigun. Reason for that is I kind of like to take something that is maybe a high single target damage and then a bunch of splash damage. And we'll go ahead and take potato is for a specific thing. Sure, we'll just do picking up power-ups because there are so many. Potato is for a specific achievement that I think is on a different map. You have to pick up 3 of them or something like that. I never bothered because I didn't really, I don't know. I'm not an achievement hunter. I kind of don't care. So I wasn't worrying about it. We'll just go ahead and take the handgun because we want to upgrade that too. We can wait a little longer on getting the tank's weapon upgraded. I'm not worried about it. We're getting close to the 5-minute mark here, and of course, as it goes with all of these games, even though you're playing a round of 20 minutes, by the time you account for all of your level up and decision-making time, You're definitely going to play more than whatever the round says it's going to be. There you go. Perfect. We'll take the minigun. Once we get that upgraded, that will shred all sorts of things, including doing pretty decent damage to the bosses. Right now, I'm not as concerned about the damage on the trash because the explosive arrows are more or less covering that, and the minigun's going to handle that as well. I mean, really. There we go. We'll just go ahead and take a little power up there. Sure, we'll go ahead and finish out the bombing strike. I'm all right with that. It's going to get us an additional call in, an additional spot that's going to drop and explode. It's all good in my book. There we go. Grab all these upgrades. I haven't really talked about the little upgrades you find around the map. They're kind of the usual ones you would expect. The red one there, all of these red ones obviously are health. This lightning bolt one here is going to be speed, so movement speed. Sure, we'll take the ability cooldown. I'm fine with that. That gets our other things up running faster. There's also a armor upgrade, so like an invulnerability for a few moments. There you go. See, we took some really solid damage there, and that's going to take a minute to recover from, which is why I'm prioritizing picking up the health markers. As I said, it will get worse. You can't get too cocky here. The other upgrade that you can pick up, aside from the magnet, would be the killing one. Basically increases fire rate and I think reload, and then of course there's the money one, which we didn't really talk about, but money is, as you collect money, you'll see kind of in the top right corner there, we have 1140 out of 5450. As you collect money and you reach that point where you have collected the maximum required for that level, that's going to give you an ability point that you can spend after the round has ended and you go to your general account upgrades. There's the killing frenzy one. Yeah, that one's a handy one to have running, let me tell you. So right now we have 9 ability points that we're going to be able to spend once this round is over, and I've already spent oodles of them because I have played this game quite a bit. This is a really good one. I really enjoy it. If nothing else, I mean, look at the graphics. They're pretty good. I mean, the kind of standard fare that you see, I don't know. There is no standard fare for these games, honestly. There really isn't. Some are more pixel graphics. Some are more like this, where it's a little more 3D stuff. You know, they're actual models and you got lighting effects and all sorts of things, but it's a good-looking game, for especially when you consider what kind of game it is. I mean, I'm not saying it's, you know, Crysis or whatever the new... This game is amazing-looking. I guess maybe Remnant 2 or maybe Alan Wake 2, I'm not sure. But it is pretty darn good-looking. Like, it's genuinely really nice to look at. It's cool. It's a good game. I enjoy it. And I might be playing it at a higher resolution than I'm supposed to right now. So things might not be quite scaled as correctly as they should be. I don't know. It is one of those things where this, unfortunately, is a game that seems to synchronize its settings across devices. And then it seems to maybe want to forget that I changed the settings. So I don't know. That's one of those things, if you have a Steam Deck, then you know how annoying that is. And I believe that's also not allowed for a game to be Steam Deck verified. It cannot synchronize its graphical settings across devices because, quite frankly, the graphic settings I use on the Steam Deck are not going to be the same as I use on my desktop. And I'm very annoyed when they synchronize those settings. I want to say that maybe Horizon... whatever, which one is on the PC, Forbidden Dawn, Horizon Zero West Dawn, whatever. I think that one synchronizes some settings too, which it's not supposed to, and that one is verified, but that's not a bullet heaven, so we'll just stop talking about that for the moment. You can see things are starting to get a little hinky now. There are lots of bosses everywhere. I mean, we've got two on screen right there, and we've got more arrows in place. Oh, there's another one who just came in. Thanks for that. And yet we've got more of them coming in because you can see all those red dots and the red arrows just going on. This is why I was trying to prioritize getting some weapon upgrades for the tank, and I really wanted to have that minigun good to go because you can see these guys have a lot of health now. I mean, they are definitely tanking quite a bit of stuff. The trash mobs are still going down. They're not an issue. But the bosses are definitely soaking up some damage now. They're not quite full-on bullet sponges. We'll take some additional movement speed. I always like to move faster in these games. But they are certainly sponge-like thus far. And as we continue on here, so we're down to the last 30 seconds of this run. Yeah, it definitely gets interesting as you get closer to the end. I mean, it just kind of turns into wave after wave after wave of bosses. And yeah, we're not even going to be able to, here, we'll finish Bombing Strike. We're not even going to be able to finish anywhere near anyone's. Oh, see, there we go. There's the syringe gun. There's the first gun upgrade for the medic, but we're not going to finish anyone's stuff. That's just not going to happen. The only thing I'm interested in right now is trying to find another magnet, but I don't think there are any because I was hoping to be able to grab some more money since we're like right on the edge of a level up. There you go. We have reached the 20-minute mark. It is daylight. We have survived. We are successful. We'll take a look at the end here. You can see that you get basically your DPS by character. I mean, explosive arrows, 1174. Yeah. Minigun, 3, 1231. I'm telling you, the minigun is good. I like it a lot. And then the medic didn't do much in terms of damage, but she definitely gave us a lot of survivability. So that didn't really unlock anything because, you know, so much is already upgraded. You can see here is your upgrade field. We're at level 79, so that's 79 upgrades have been put in place out of 100, I believe. I mean, you can see I kind of stopped upgrading health because it didn't matter. Kind of stopped upgrading defense because it didn't matter. But at this point, you know, there's definitely stuff to do. Like this one, I haven't used the lock selections. I probably should, but I kind of know all the things I want, so I just haven't worried too much about it. But basically, a lot of different upgrades. We won't worry too much about that. I'll just show you. The last thing here is that here you have all your characters. We didn't see all of them, so SWAT is ranged rifle guns. Kind of starts with a pistol, goes up to, I want to say like an Uzi or an SMG or something, and ends up with an assault rifle, which is pretty good. You can see their assault rifle or sniper rifle, that's his upgrade path. The engineer is eventually kind of ends up with, I don't know, it's like a plasma rifle that is either a plasma rifle or like a laser rifle, that plasma doing more area damage, the laser being more focused on single target damage. And then the ghost uses a katana, which upgrades into, again, kind of similar paths where there's just like a bunch of cuts landing all over the place or more in a singular line. Ghost is a lot of fun. All these characters are a lot of fun, actually. I like them. I didn't mean to start that. And then as we select the arena here, you can see there are some different options. So we have the default game mode, which is for 20 minutes, endless, hardcore, which is a 10-minute run and is stronger, a boss rush, which is just bunches of bosses, and then a one hit where if you get hit once, you're done. That's basically the game. It's a lot of fun. I really enjoy this one, and apparently I can't even do that one because I haven't unlocked. I thought I did hardcore, I guess not. If you're interested at all in Bullet Heaven games, I highly suggest checking this one out. As I said very early on, I'm pretty sure that by the time this video posts, if not by then shortly after, we're going to have the next major update. And this game continues to be updated, and from what I have seen so far, it is updated very well. Catch you another one, Till, and thanks for watching. See you later.